All right. So most persons that are very successful tend to become very successful. I can tell you categorically that most people that have been very successful in our business are people that are already very successful in so many other businesses and in their career. I'm telling you, they don't joke with their job. They don't joke with their businesses. I've seen it. They are the people excelling. When they join our business, they excel much more. Now, you must understand that I've always said this. Success is not in the business. Success is dependent on you. Success is you. You are the one that makes all the difference. And I always teach and tell people, you are the real business. You are the real business. When you see something going on well in your business, in this business, check yourself. There must be something you are doing that is making it successful. It's always about you. Success is who you are. That is why it's not about how much you are making. It's about who you are becoming. And one of the threats, one of the things you will notice about successful people is that they review their lives, they review their activities, they review their businesses at every given point in time. Let me tell you the truth. If you value something, you will want to have reports on that particular thing every now and then. For example, you give birth to a child and then you leave that child with someone because there is an exam you need to take and they don't need to have you carry your child to the exams. And that child is so, so little, and then you have someone, maybe not your mom or your dad, okay, you know, with that child. What will happen? You want to keep finding out the state of that child. Is that not true? Let me see, wave your hand if it's true. All right, if you know it's true, let me see you wave your hand. All right, that's very true. Do you know why? That child is very important to you. I learned it from someone called Grant Cardone. I learned a lot about sales, closing. I'm telling you, the reason why I can close the way I close on people is because that guy unapologetically, the man does not look at people, you know, when he's closing. He tells you, come on, this is the right thing to do now. Do it now. You know, I learned a lot from him. And one of the things he said that changed my life is he said there is a particular report that they give to him every 15 minutes. And he pointed out it was an online program. I paid, I think, about $400 for that training. $400 for a seminar. Do the calculation. That's what I paid. Almost 200,000 naira. That's what I paid. In fact, if you put the charges, it's more than 200,000. Yes. I'm telling you, for 2 days program online. And one of the things he now turned and said, if there is a certain aspect of your business, a key determinant of success and growth in your business, if you know that, if you don't demand for review, if you don't review and demand for reports on that, it shows high gross of unseriousness, high level of unseriousness, gross unseriousness from you. That day it dawned on me, wow, I've not really been reviewing my life. When you review your life, it shows how often you review your life, shows how healthy you are. You must be comfortable reviewing your activities. When I'm experiencing a boom in my business, I'm not a fool. What I do is this, I sit down. What is it that's giving me this what? Boom. I want to keep doing it. Is this spiritually? Is it physically? There was a time I had serious dryness and I found out that personally and emotionally, I was very, very dry. I couldn't be creative. I was asking myself, what's wrong with you, man? It's not you. I will schedule a tax. I will procrastinate that tax 1,001 times. And there was nothing wrong with me health-wise. You know, kind of like I'm sick. But I was sick emotionally and mentally. And that day, it dawned on me. Hey, that was years back. I said, hey, I have to learn to create an environment of positivism, an environment of enthusiasm, of an environment of positivity, because it's a strategy for me. So I don't like negative energy. I create as a strategy. Why? Because I've reviewed myself and I've seen it. I did a review on our business last weekend. And I found that something that we are doing so well in the past, but now we are going down. And I take responsibility. What is it? Two things. Number one, our invitations. Number two, people are no longer graduating through foundation class. So I had to tell myself, come on, guy, you just have to fix this as early as possible. Now, and I asked myself a question, what really caused this slack? Because it is not just good enough to come and beat yourself, you know, and say, oh, I didn't do it. No. Find out what caused it. And I noticed that, wow, a lot of people are now joining the foundation class and I copied it, and the way I used to call all of them and then make sure you go through, Mr. Christian, you remember, make sure you submit your report. Make sure you do it. Mr. Edward, thank you. You remember that. Make sure you send that report. Make sure. I was no longer coping with it. And I found out that I was not really instructing my success clients to really, you know, on the importance of the foundation class. So it was just dawned on me that I have not really dug deep or taught us in detail, you know, the importance of starting a new partner rightly. The reason why many of you just started and everything is flowing so well is because you were started off the right way. There is a proper way to start a new partner. And when you don't start them off properly, trust me, the level of enthusiasm and the level of excitement they use in making the payment will go down. And once it goes down, it will take divine intervention for them to be back. All of you here in this millionaire school, attending millionaire school regularly, and it seems, in quote, nothing is happening for me, right? You don't even know what you are doing. You are building a very powerful foundation. Remember, what is the most important is not how much you are making, it's about who you are becoming. You are becoming more of a disciplined person. You are becoming more focused. Do you know what it means that every morning you are attending a school? Every morning you are attending lectures. Every morning you have a series of activities you are doing. I always teach. Who will remind me here? What is my number one greatest secret of success? Mr. Toby, you should know that. My number one greatest secret of success. Number one greatest secret, as in, if someone tells me now, where is, you know, someone tells the way they did, they ask the way Samson, you know, the success of the source of Samson's strength is his hair. What is it that if you watch me, you see me, as in, people, you, Mr. Toby, you should know that. What is it that is my greatest secret that has kept me to be very consistent in my result? Mr. Toby, can you guess? I've asked that question before and you got it rightly more than two times.
Hello?
Yeah, can you guess?
Yeah, routine.
Perfect! My routine. My secret in my business, as in the core secret, if you're talking about the embodiment of my secret in my business, is a routine. But you, many of you, don't even know what I'm doing. What I've done is to creatively put you in a place where you are following a routine, but you don't even know. A routine of waking up in the morning and listening to an inspiring message in the millionaire school. A routine of waking up in the morning and listening to trainings that will help you build your business. That's the learning part. And a routine, this is where I'm not monitoring you then. And a routine of always making phone call. That is why I said, if you are here in the millionaire school and then you are following up with actions, because it's not just to be here. When I close this millionaire school, how many of you will dump every single thing you've learned instead of putting it to practice? How many of you will follow up and make sure that you are doing your assignments? How many of you are reading the books? How many of you are making the 20 phone calls and invitations every day? Now, let me say this. All of you that are following me and doing all this, you don't even know what you are doing to yourself. You are building yourself. You are setting yourself up for a great and massive success in the future. Why? Because you are actually creating a routine. I'm telling you, Do you know that I don't even feel normal again to say I'm not having millionaire school? I've been asking myself, what have I been doing in this business for God's sake? Last year that everybody was asking, if we have millionaire school, if we say we're having meeting, sometimes partners meeting 100. But anyway, that's life. You know, we keep growing. Creating a routine. And I kept teaching it last year. Why didn't I build a routine that can get people to, you know, a routine mode? That's what you are doing here. A routine mode. I'm putting you to a mode. But the reason why you are able to get into this mode easier is because you went through your foundation class. So one of the things I have found out, is that many of us don't know the importance of starting off a new partner well. Now, listen to me. Listen to me carefully. A new partner is someone that, first of all, you must show him high level of seriousness. Let me open up the... I didn't plan to teach this today, but let's open up. I have a slide on it. Yes. In my RDI, I told us I have so many trainings I've worked on. Dream Alive trainings, starting off your new partner well, starting in new franchisees. That's one of the things, that's one of the best things that have happened to us in RDI. We have good materials. I'm telling you, we have great resources. I've really, by God's special grace, I've been able to work on great resources. I'm telling you, it's just the special grace of God. You know, it's just the special grace of God. We have good materials. I can tell you that we have good materials. Very powerful ones. One of the best in the world. So let me just, I thought I have the PowerPoint. This is the PDF. Let me open the PowerPoint. I will send us the PDF after. Thought I have the okay. Yeah. Start up a new franchisee. I know I have the PowerPoint, so that we use it to project. Perfect. That's it. Okay. Let me share the slide. I want us to really have an insight on this. Okay. You need to know the importance. All right, now because it's for all of us here. Once you connect anybody into the business, you need to understand this. Getting new people started or new partners started. Get your distributor started right. Only then will your retention rate goes up. Okay, what's your retention rate? The proportion of people that joins your business and finally stays. See, let me tell us the truth. It's not everybody that joins your business that will stay. You've not seen drama. Somebody, you will see people telling you, I am here for you. Mr. Nonso, I want you to hold me by the hand, sir. I'm going to go and borrow money and start this business now. In your mind, you'll be saying, Kawai. Mr. Toby, you are laughing. In your mind, you'll be saying, Kawai, man, I don't get a leader. I don't get somebody that will walk. I don't get somebody that I will pour myself into. And you're already making plans on how to pour yourself into them. You've not seen people. Immediately they pay their money, you give them username and password. Vroom. Some of them said, we're not even logging to the username. We're not even using. You won't see them again. You send message to know even how they are feeling, to know whether something bad happened. You know, some of them will even block you. You've not seen anything, though. Nothing. See, there is nothing we never see. Do you know how many persons have recruited in this business? There is nothing you will not see in this business. Some of them maybe even tell you, can you please help me? Can you just help me to complete the money? You go and even put 10,000, 20, complete the money for them, thinking that this one, immediately they register. That is the end. Get ready. There is nothing we've not seen. That is why you must, through faith and patience, follow after those. You must follow after those through patience and faith endured. Yes. And they entered the promise. That is the scriptures. That's why you have to follow after us. See, let me tell you, people will show you, they could show you as a life and a side of them you've never seen. So get ready for it. And guess what? This is what I call emotional blackmail. Somebody, you are sending messages every day. You are sending him message every day. He is receiving your messages. He's not responding to you. You give him a phone call, he will not hear you. He will not talk to you. He will not respond. One day, he will now wake up in the morning and send you a stinker. Look at what you introduced me to. I'm so much disappointed. Let me tell you the truth. It's called emotional blackmail. Make that thing not enter you at all. If such a thing, fire the person back, bumper to bumper, but let her come back and tell the person, see, I am still here for you. Do you know I've been waiting on you? Are you not reading my messages? You are black. Put it to the person, you are blackmailing me emotionally. And if you are doing this intentionally, stop it, because it's not a good attitude. End it. That's not good. Since you registered into this business, I've been calling on you, trying to help you. How best again will I show you that I want to help you? Have you ever picked my call? Don't let anybody blackmail you emotionally. I am telling you the truth, especially those of you that are leaders, because plenty partners, they are specialists in doing that. They gave A1 distinction in doing it. Don't let anyone, as in, at a time it was like, I've seen a lot of people, leaders, that this thing destroyed. They'll be like, I don't want to do this business again. Can you imagine? People are even telling me that I deceived them. I say, Jesus, the people you are talking about, do they attend your meeting? No. Do they attend, do follow you what you are teaching? No. I said, they are the ones that are scams. They are scammers. Because they knew from the onset that this is a business and you have been there trying to help them, but they will sideline you. You know, there are some people that is until they hit rock bottom, their brain will not come back. And when their brain comes back, they will not look for who to blame. So we are not talking about them. But there are people that they need to be started off well. And if the percentage of the people, if you are not retaining people that are joining you in this business, trust me, if you are not retaining some persons, your business is not growing. So, Mama Akala, Mama Princess, you remember we had a discussion last time, okay, about the people you are introducing and then making sure that they graduate out. And I remember I told you, it's only Madam Owe here that I have now, I'm holding. And I told you, make sure your sister and make sure Mr. Williams, make sure you are on them. Make sure you are on them. Make sure they graduate out of the foundation class this week. It is your responsibility. So if the people are not started off well, your retention rate will not go up. Okay? And it's only when your retention rate goes up that you will see some real and consistent growth in your business. Now, look at this. A new distributor, a new partner has the following attributes. Every new person coming into the business, they have this attribute. Number one who hasn't seen the vision clearly. They've not seen the vision clearly. Listening to me for 65 minutes or 70 minutes in the video or in the OPP business meeting at 8 p.m. is not enough for them to see the vision of RODI, to know how great and how wonderful the opportunity is. A new partner is one who is desperate to see his first results. Every new partner is desperate. So that's the reason why once you join my millionaire's club, I calm you down. Calm down. Be calming. Relax. They are desperate to see the first result. And you have to help them. They are desperate. Number three, one that is in a testing mode. Anybody that joins the business new, no matter how committed you are showing me, in my mind, you are in a testing mode to know whether the business is worth of your time. How many of you can see all these things in yourself when you connected to this business early? Let me see you. Let me see you wave your hand. Exactly. All of us, we were there. Number four, one likened to an engine. A new partner is someone likened to an engine, but needs to be kickstarted in order to run and function appropriately. A powerful engine. All of you here, I'm seeing you as someone very powerful beyond your wildest imagination. Trust me, I'm seeing all of you here listening to me having 10,000 partners each tied to your loins. But what I need to do is to kickstart you, is to make sure you are running properly. That is it. I'm seeing potentials in you that you're not even seeing. That's reality. Now, steps to get your partner started rightly. Number one, validation. Validation. Call them and congratulate them. Tell them you've made the right decision. You made the right decision. Yes, this is the best decision that you've ever made. All right? Now, you need to call them and tell them that. Don't make them feel that, oh, you know, they are scared. Some of them, even when they pay money, in their heart, they say, be like, eh? Maybe I've seen someone, people, they pay money. How many of you have noticed it? Someone pays money, and then they now send me a message, and I was chatting with them before they make payment. And when they now made the payment and sent me payment details, and maybe I'm carried away by something else, and then the message has been there for like 2 hours, 3 hours. They'll be like, hello, hello, what is going on? You will literally see the unsettlement in them. How many of you have noticed it? What is going on now? They are scared. At that point in time, it's as if they made a wrong decision. No, they didn't make a wrong decision. You need to call them, my dear. You just made one of the best decisions in your life. Do you know you are one of the just less than 5% of the world population that are actually working on their financial freedom? Thank God I've taught my Rising Star mentors. This week, all my Rising Star mentors, get ready for me. I'll be working with you individually before Saturday. In all those things we said we're going to set up, we will put most of them in place before Saturday. So even if, listen, all of you here, it doesn't take an eye stand. It doesn't take something special. Call them on phone and tell them, my dear, you will enjoy the business. Don't worry. I myself, together with the leaders, going to make sure you succeed in this business. Just be willing to work with us. Revalidate them. That's what is called validation. They need it from you. Number two, set their expectations. Make sure they are actually operating well. That's what it is. Set their expectations aright. Very, very, very important. Now, let me just rush it through so we can get to the discussions proper. Make sure they are prepared. Number four, create a plan together. And number five, give them assignments. All right, so let's get and deal with them. Take out moment, talking about validation. Take out moment to do what? To congratulate your new distributor for joining and say something about how they have now taken control of their life. Reassure them that they have made the right decision. Look at an example of it. Good morning, Mr. Ahmad. On behalf of Dream Alive, on behalf of RDINGO, I want to congratulate you for taking this bold step towards creating a future you truly desire. You may not know, sir, but you are among just 5% of the world population who have decided to take responsibility of their financial life. You are a success, sir. Congrats once more. We, the RDI family, is happy to have you. Do have a lovely day. By doing this, you will erase any lasting doubts that they have. Even if they have any doubt at all, you will erase it in their mind. And you make them feel that they have made a good decision. That's the power of what? Validation. That's the power of validation. Make sure you validate them. Somebody attends your meeting. Don't just validate people that have registered. Validate also people that attended the meeting. Call them on phone and thank them for attending the meeting. What's the next thing? The next thing is what? Set their expectations. Number one, you must understand that there is what we call unrealistic expectations and goals. They are one of the biggest reasons why new partners drop out. Unrealistic expectations and goals. So your job is to make sure they know what to expect. That's the reason why many of you, you see the way I call you on phone, you see the way here, even in the Zoom meeting, I tell you, you are going well. You are doing well. Mr. Christian Awaraka, you invited somebody the other day. The person contacted me, teaching you that as you are building your follow-up list, that's the right thing to do. It is your responsibility to set the expectations and goals rightly. Because people that come into the business, they come on, see. People can really, they come in with what I call Ponzi scheme mentality. I just started now with 50 or 200,000 naira. I hope that every month I should be making now 50,000 naira. They don't know that there is something called what? Business building. It is your responsibility to calm them down and nurture them. That's why I'm here to nurture you. Tell them that their success or failure is up to them. That they are in charge of their success. If they fail, they are the ones that created the failure. If they succeed, they created their own success. You are there to support and guide them. Secondly, your job is to help your new distributors become independent of you as quickly as possible. How do you do that? You follow our RDI system. Our RDI system is what helps you to get people to become independent of you. For example, I'm looking forward in the next 3 months to 6 months to get my rising star mentors becoming influential mentors. By so doing, do you know what's happening now? I will collapse, I will remove them from my millionaire school and they will start running their own millionaire school. I will take out time. There will be a particular day I'll be working with all my influential mentors. I will sit down with them, set timetables for them, everything they will teach throughout the week. The same way now, Emily Augusta is running her own millionaire school. Madam Blessing, running her own millionaire school. The same way I'm supposed to raise you to be running your own millionaire school. Very, very vital. Turn this fan away from me, please. Is it affecting me? Turn this fan away from me, please. Sorry. Yeah, that's better. Very, very important. It's your responsibility to make them become independent of you. And you follow the RDI system. When does people start expressing a level of independency? Rising Star Mentor. For example, all my Rising Star Mentors, now this week you are creating your own foundation class WhatsApp groups. And you will have your own videos, the complete videos and all the messages you will send in. You see that? And then you'll now start handling that. Now, I will not be the one again handling all foundation classes. You see that? That's growth. From there, you start running your own millionaire school. Okay? Run your own millionaire school. That's where you start doing your own registrations. I will add you to the code room. You will learn how to clear payments yourself. I will no longer be clearing payments for you. You will not be the one communicating with the offices the way I communicate with them. Collect the code. Do the registration yourself. You will understand all the genealogy of your account. You will know where you are. I have to teach you how to do registration. You have to learn it. It's your responsibility. It's your responsibility. Number three, make sure they are prepared. Share with them testimonies and help them have their own testimonies too. That's why I'm always excited anytime someone tells me, oh, he signs up a new partner. I'll be like, oh, you will make money. Because I know the joy. I know what it is. Give your new partners the appropriate tools. Third-party tools such as third-party call sheets, recommendation flyers, questionnaires. Actually, this is actually an old manner. Prospecting videos to build up a large and successful business. So make sure your distributors have the appropriate tools to help them through the exposure process with the new prospects. That's the reason why we don't allow you to talk to people when you join our business newly. We take you through the process of having the right materials. Let me just finish up this section so we can induct our new partners. I've started seeing our new partners here. I've seen Mr. Anthony. Mr. Anthony, good to have you. Yes, yes, yes. Mr. Anthony is part of the people we are actually inducting today. I can see Madam Liberty. Yes, 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 yes. This is awesome. This is awesome. Who again do I have here? Do I have Madam Ikeobi and do I have Emmanuel? Do I have Emmanuel? If I don't have Emmanuel, Madam Izuka, make sure you call Mr. Emmanuel. Let him join the meeting if he's available. Wow, we have our millionaire school today being exploded. I love this. We are tech something. We are really growing in our millionaire school. All right, so let's finish up this lecture and have the induction. Make sure your new partners get connected. What does it mean to get connected? Make sure they are you connect them to the appropriate channels. Connect them to your team's WhatsApp groups and other platforms to enable them to bond with other team members and also have access to updated information about the company. Teach them how to use their DTC. You see, what is the DTC? Your private section of your business, on your online account, distributors tracking center. Teach them how to do encashments and how to link their bank accounts. You see, that's why I'm doing all those things. So now you are seeing the reason why I'm doing them. Explain more to them the compensation plan so that your distributors have at least a basic understanding of it. Don't talk too much about uni level, stair step, and the different ranks, except for silver executive in detail here. Done. That's the reason why we don't discuss all those ranking things. They don't need all the details, but they should be able to know what will happen financially as they move through the first few levels. Teach them how to properly invite their prospects and to hear more about what they have to offer. to hear more about what they have to offer. Yes, your partners will have a better time getting started if they at least know how the professional invitation process works. Do you see that? They will have a better time starting, you know, building their business when they understand early enough how to invite people professionally. That's the reason why in every of our induction, the first thing I teach you is how to invite people, not how to talk to anybody, how to make the professional invitation. Very, very vital. So let's finish up quickly. Number four, create a plan together. Sit down with your new partners. Sit down with them. I believe this training is majorly for those of you that are Rising Star mentors. Those of you that are Rising Star mentors, you are expected to, as in, I will send this material to you. You must digest this material. It is meant for you. Sit down with your new partners and discuss on a plan to have their first matching bonuses and their first 1 million. Do you see why we created a 90 days challenge? Plan with them to become a Rising Star mentor in maximum 2 months. Plan with them to attend their first AIM Global upcoming events and RODI NGO recognition events. As from next week, or before the end of the month, we'll be talking about the RODI recognition events that we'll be having either at the end of the year or within the first quarter of next year. That will be our very first major recognition events. Okay, if your new distributors can get results quickly, then they will be more likely to continue. It's your responsibility. Number five, give them assignments. A new partner is one hungry for direction. So give him a simple task to begin with and give them a deadline. Give them an assignment that will help them to get over the line towards success. Example, getting their first customer or distributor, proclaiming their intentions to the world. Are you hearing me? Get them to learn to share their intentions to the world. You need to help them build their confidence in the business so as to boldly share it with people. You need to help them to boost their confidence. Things you should never do while starting a new partner. Do not give a new partner multiple books to read. One book at a time. Yes. Let me just do that faster. Don't ever tell a new partner some of the company's challenges, because every business has a challenge. This one, they're available. This company, we have offices in only about 8 places in Nigeria. No. Haba. Do not tell a new partner that they must come to office every day. This one is fiscal presentation. Okay. Him or her should have the free, should be free to work with you on their own time. Time freedom. Then repeat the initial franchise orientation and the smart starter guide as many times as possible with your partners. Did you hear what I said? All of you that went through foundation class, you don't finish foundation class. So that's the reason why many of you will notice, but I do this very technical. How many of you will notice that in the millionaire school, I keep teaching you the importance of multiple accounts? I keep teaching you about expectation management. So the structure I created is this. In every of our inductions is an opportunity to remind the old persons of the IFO and the Smart Starter Guide. So you will notice that during inductions, the questions I normally ask is centered on the IFO, New Franchisees Orientation, and the Smart Starter Guide. Because even you that is old in the business, you've been there. You need to keep yourself reminded of these things regularly. You need it regularly. You need to be regular with it. All right. So this training, I believe that, you know, I really want us to really take it to heart. Okay. I'm going to stop the recording.